Well, Yulia Lipnitskaya was one of the big stars for Russia in Sochi last winter, and her first Grand Prix assignment of the season was the Cup of China. She finished in second place there. She wasn't happy about that, and she actually didn't show up for the medal ceremony.
You don't say.
She's not shy about letting you know when she's not happy.
Yeah. And she got fined for it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, she's known for not coming to the podium.
Yeah, she's done it three times.
I just forgot there was a medal ceremony.
Yep.
Who knows?
Well, she can qualify now for the final with a first or second place finish here.
To say that having a little bit of diva in you isn't a bad thing. You watch her landings. She has a very unusual way of landing her jumps. She doesn't really drastically and quickly check out of the rotation. She seems to just sort of unfold. She gave you three beautiful landing positions to have a good look at in that first pass. Not a triple-triple, double axle, triple-toe, double-toe. And she's really putting the double axle, triple-toe through its paces, and she has what I would call a very bad technique on her double axle, but it seems to work
for her.
Works
for her, yeah.
Skating, keep saying it, moments of absolute genius, crossovers and general skating skills, not one of the highlights. And she's stuck between being that young, youthful presence on the ice that she was in Sochi and not quite made the step up yet, but not quite the little girl anymore either.
Feeling with this program I had with her short, it races around the rink. It just goes on and on and on, and there's no pause like that. I want to see more of that. Give me a moment when I can enjoy those things that she does so beautifully.
Spins are rarely commented on when it comes to who wins and who loses, but whenever she does spin, she racks up points. Just not as much as an impact on your big score as those jumps are.
reigning world silver medalist Ulia Lipnitskaya, and no doubt she's uber talented, but at times it's like she's going through a checklist of technical elements as she skates.
Little nuances, like the end of the music. If the music's over, don't do that last pose to show us that you're late. Just keep your hand up and stay. But those instinctive moments within the music, she looks programmed. And you can't do that.
Ulia Lipnitskaya was in second place after the short program, 1 point behind Radionova. As we know, Lipnitskaya needs to finish first or second to make it to the Grand Prix final.
Here's a look at that double axle. She spins, sort of swings around that free leg. It doesn't go whooshing through. That double axle will never really have that Unikim flair to it. And this program, well, it's interesting. Every relationship starts out exciting, and then the reality sets in, and do you last? And I think that's what's going on with me now. I'm seeing her in a different way. I'm noticing things about her crossovers. I was smitten at first, but is she lasting the test of time?
Well, maybe we're ready to see her move on to something more complex, but she's not quite ready to go there.
We just saw Ashley Wagner perform, and that's what I would call a sophisticated, well-directed program. She did create moments within the music. Ownership was there. And unfortunately, of course, there was a technical mistake there, and she, she left points out there that she didn't need to lose. But at the same time, I'm wondering about the second score, the skating program components, the musicality, the interpretation, the in-between steps.
In her defense, though, she's been so busy with skating shows since the Sochi Olympics. She hasn't trained maybe as much as she would like to. But
you can learn a lot doing skating shows, Brenda.
True enough. Okay, her score puts her into first place with one skater left to come. So a mission accomplished for her. She will finish no lower than in second place. So what that means is she will be heading off to the Grand Prix final.